Hi again and welcome. Today we're going to talk about doing maintenance on your computer, keep it running up to speed, getting rid of things you don't need, deleting some things, temporary files. Temporary files, every time you go to a website, anything you type in, www.whatever, every page you go to on that webpage is all saved in a temporary file. And these files can get pretty big, and eventually what will happen is they'll start slowing down your computer. So the first thing we're going to want to do is we're going to go to Control Panel, and we're going to go to Programs and Features, or Add and Remove, depending on which Windows system you're talking about. Go through this list. If there's anything in here that you loaded, games, toolbars especially, you should only have one or two toolbars. You don't need more than that. You could end up with six, seven, or eight of them in here. I don't know if I have one here. I should have a Google toolbar here somewhere. Yeah, here we go. Google toolbar for Internet Explorer. Toolbar, that's a key word. If you have four, five, or six of them, delete some of them. You don't need them all. You only need to use one or two, and your toolbar. Just to go over it again, I have talked about this in our browser video, but this is the toolbar right here. If you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 toolbars going across the top of your screen, go in, close them, keep one, you only need one, come in here to your add and remove, and uninstall them. If you want to keep the Google toolbar, there's Bing toolbar, there's Ask.com toolbar, there's Yahoo toolbar, there's tons and tons and tons of toolbars. A lot of times when you download programs off the internet, they come with a toolbar. So after you download a program from the internet, come in here and look and see if they added a toolbar in your list. If they did, just simply delete it. Like I said, any games, any programs, stuff you don't use, stuff that doesn't work, uninstall. Simply double click on it. Yep. Probably shouldn't have done that, but that's okay. Uninstall it. Let it go through. And get rid of them. Go through the whole list. Other than that, what you want to do next is you want to go back to your start menu, go to Programs, go to Accessory, go back to System Tools, and you're going to go to Disk Cleanup. You want to do Drive C, which is your main drive. If you have a computer that's got separate areas, C drive, D drive, whatever you want, you can add that to the list. Click OK. And what that's going to do is go through a screen. That other screen is just going to take a minute, so. It's going to go through, it's going to get all your temporary files. There's stuff in here called System Error Memory Dump Files, which is any error that occurs when the pages are loaded, any error that happens on your system. That stuff is all saved. You don't need that stuff. If you have a problem, your tech might want to use these error messages to try and pinpoint the problem, stuff like that. But just let this load. Takes a minute. Not long. Minute and a half. And then when it's done, it's going to come up with a list of all the files that it's checked. Your system dump file is generally your biggest file. It'll also tell you how much space on your hard drive you're using with all these files that are in here. Then we're going to talk about disk defrag. I'll show you how to do that. Disk defrag is all the files that are on your computer, on your hard drive. And it's going to show you which ones are broken and corrupted, or which ones can be combined into one, how to put things together. That's why this was taking long. It was that other program was running in the background. Okay, what we have here is download program files. anything you downloaded from the internet, temporary internet files, offline pages. If you work offline, you'll have pages, your recycle bin, and it tells you how much room they use. 14.2 megs of temporary internet files. That's a little bit. I've seen it a lot worse than that. You can scroll down, like recycle bin. My recycle bin here is empty. There's nothing in it. What else? Thumbnails. Windows error reports, system archive window error reports, and it gives you a total of 64.4 megabytes. That's not too bad. It hasn't been that long since I've done this, but I've seen this at 1 and 2 gig of memory space. And that's just using up space on your hard drive that you really don't need to be using. You simply just click yes or OK, delete files, and it's just going to go through and delete all those files. The next thing we're going to talk about is we're going to talk about your startup menu. I've talked about this briefly in other videos. Windows Vista, Windows 7, Windows 8, you can go to Control Panel, go to Windows Defender, go to Tools, and then you go to Software Explorer. And what this does is, yeah, I actually have one in here I can show you, Weatherbug. I don't need that starting up. These are programs. Right here it says Startup Programs. Make sure that's on a list. If it's not, just go down here and find it, click on it, make sure it says that. And then these are all the programs on your computer that start up every time you turn your computer on. So if you're the type of person that turns your computer off every time you're done using it, when you turn it back on, it's going to take time for everything to load. The more these programs that are in your start menu, the longer it's going to take for your computer to load or boot up, so they call it. And if what you want to do is you can go in here, if there's something that you don't use too often that's in the list, or something you don't use at all, just click on it till it turns blue, and click remove. Are you sure you want to remove this? Yes. And it doesn't stop the program from working. I can still go to my start menu, to programs, Weatherbug. It'll still run if I turn it on from here. What it'll do is it'll stop it from running automatically every time you turn your computer on. So that can speed up your process. There's some things that won't let you delete or remove. Certain things have to be removed. Have to be running, I mean. What else? That's it for control panels. The next thing you want to do, you can also look on your programs here. There is a startup folder that should be empty unless there's something specific you want to start up when you turn your computer on. If you want Weatherbug or something like that to start up, then you can simply go to Weatherbug, go to Weatherbug, right click, copy, go to your start menu. Do it from here, I think. Open. See how that was? Yeah, there you open. And then right click and paste. And then when you close this, you go to your programs, go to your start menu, and here's Weatherbug. And that will automatically turn on when you turn your computer on. If you don't want it here, simply right click, delete. Are you sure? Yes. The other thing you can do for your temporary files, click your start menu, you go to run, you put in percent, shift percent, T-E-M-P, and percent again, and hit OK. And this is a list of all your temporary files. I've deleted this recently, so there's not a lot in here. This page can get pretty full. And what you want to do is just go to Organize, select all, they all light up, right click on any of them, and delete. Yes. Now you're going to run into one I'll show you here. It's going to say can't be deleted, skip it, or try again. This action cannot be completed because the file is open in another program. So if there's something running, just hit skip for now. hit skip again. And if you keep getting a bunch of them, just check this box. Do this for all current items. There's only one left. Skip. And let it go. And it deletes all those temporary files. Close that. You can go back to your run. Startup programs. You can also do this way. If you have Windows 98, 2000, NT, XP, you have to do your startup programs this way. Windows Vista, Windows 7, Windows 8, you can go into your control panel and use Windows Defender. But just click on the run, type in here msconfig, 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 hit OK. Go to your startup button. And these are all programs also that run on your computer. There's not a lot here. That's not too many. Google updates, my web search, registry. This is all stuff that has to be running. What you want to be looking for is programs, games, like WeatherBug, stuff like that, that you loaded and put in your start menu. And simply if there's anything in here, like if WeatherBug was in here, you just simply click on it. Hit apply and hit OK. And what that'll do is that'll disable it from working. That's pretty much it for your start menus, your temporary files, your recycle bin. Right click, you can empty recycle bin. The other thing you can do, go back to your programs, go back to your accessories, back to system tools. And you're going to go to Disk Defragmenter. And what this is going to do, Windows Vista and newer, they don't really show you much of what's going on. They just, you hit defrag and you'll see the little round symbol going round and round until it's completed. The older versions, NT, XP, Vista, not Vista, but 2098, it'll actually go to a screen and it'll show you all the files that are on your hard drives. And there'll be different colored ones. I think red are fragmented, which means they're not a complete file. And you get them because when you delete something or you uninstall a program, it doesn't completely uninstall everything. So you could end up with a file with a partial program in it that doesn't work. You don't need them. You're taking up space on your hard drive. Just simply on this, you just click the defrag now and just let it go. This does take several hours to run. So just hit defrag, minimize it, and just let it run. If you want to do a little bit of work on your computer, you can. I wouldn't go playing games or videos. What you're going to do is it's going to end up slowing down your computer. Your games aren't going to play right because they'll be too slow. They'll be freezing and playing and stopping. But you can go into files, you can go into your emails, you want to go to your Facebook or Yahoo or Twitter or something like that, or if you want to go into a file and work on something, read something, that's fine. Just don't do too much at one time while this is running. But this could take, actually on mine, it takes probably a good 4 hours or so for this to completely run. So just let it run, let it finish, let it do what it's going to do. I actually don't use Windows Disk Defragger. I have another one, and I'll show you what it looks like on the older versions. Where is that file? Tune-ups. And you can if you want to load any of this stuff, feel free to. I use Defragger. It's the same thing as Disk Defrag for Windows. But I think Defragger does a little better job, and it does it much faster. It's much faster than the Windows version of Defragger. But it's totally up to you. You can simply click on it. Let it open. And what you're going to do is you're going to come down here, and you're going to... that's just saying there's a new updates. Come down here, you got defrag, and you got analyze. Click on analyze. Let it go through and do its thing. You can click on defrag and just let it start defragging. But this is the same thing that Windows Defragger will do. It just doesn't show you these files if you have Windows Vista or newer. The older versions will show you this. You can analyze it and look at it and see if you need to defrag. Sometimes you don't need to. Like, I defragged maybe a week ago, so it's not too bad. I have some red files. The red files are the ones that are fragmented that are no good. It actually shows you here, if you go to the colors, driver maps, it shows you what each color file does. Files being written. When you hit defrag, you'll see green files. Those are files that are being written. They'll combine them together. Yellow. These are just page files. You'll see yellow ones when you're defragging. Those are the ones being read. They read the file. They analyze it, decide where to put it. And what will happen is all this red stuff on the bottom will be gone, and all these blue files will be all in order. There won't be gaps between them like this, and like here, and like here. All these gaps will be filled, and they'll move these blue files up here, move this one up here. They'll fill in these blocks, so that everything's nice and neat. And what it does is it makes your computer a little faster, because right now you have files that are spaced out. There's gaps between them. And it takes your processor longer to go find all these files. And if they're all in order, nice and neat, and there's no fragmented ones, it can find these files a little faster. And like I said, this takes several hours. Just hit defrag if you want to do it. I'm not going to get into it right now, but that's how defrag works. Another one you can have here, you can go and load. A defrag you can download from the internet. Just go to defragger.com. And the other one I use is File Shredder. And what this does is you can download this. Just go to fileshredder.com or go to Google and put in fileshredder.com. Download the program. It's free. There's no problems with it. And the only thing you want to do on here is shred free space. And what that does, you click on C for your C drive and you hit Next. I'm not going to start it, but what that does is when you're in a defragger and you have all those red files and fragmented files, what this does is it actually goes in and shreds them files and deletes them. Any spaces that are useless, not being used, it deletes them and just puts everything nice and neatly together. Then the other thing you can do after you get everything completed, you can simply go to, I talked about using the restore. If you have a problem with a file, or if you lose a file, or something like that, you can go into restore, restore your computer. You can also go into restore to create a restore point. Click here, open system protection. It asks you where you want to store it. Down here to the bottom, you can create a restore point right now for your disk selection. Click create. What you do is you give it a name, anything you want. You could put in a date, whatever today's date is. You could put in the date and the time and hit create. And what that'll do is it creates a restore. So if you have a problem, you can come back to this restore point. And as I said in the other video, restore, all restore does is it saves a copy of all your settings. Your programs all have settings, games have settings, the computer operating system itself has settings, and what this is just a copy of all those settings. And if something happens, if you change something you weren't supposed to, or if you get a virus or something like that that changes your settings, sometimes you'll download a program, it can change your settings, you can simply go to this process, go to your restore. Go to the restore point that has this date and time or whatever title you put in here. You can put in a name, anything you want. And then you hit restore and it sets your computer back to all the settings it's at right now. And that's pretty much it for restore. Maintenance. Make sure you do maintenance in your computer once in a while. Depending on how often you surf the net. The more you surf the net, the more you uninstall programs, the more often you're going to have to do this. Okay, that's it for maintenance. Good luck. Thank you.